organized backstage. And so in just a few minutes, we will present to you the story of the fake.
You wanted us organized?
Yeah, we've talked about this. I mean, the organization is part of why we do this. I mean, I've got...
I can't find my hat.
I have boxes of props and hats and things. I mean, Saxon, come on, you need a hat. So that every noble man in Rome...
I got my hat, and it said I was a man.
You have to be warranted to play comedian. We all know this.
I did my work, CeCe.
She knows what she's doing.
I did it right when it says I'm a man.
But that's the wrong form, Jean-Pierre. You need the other form, the updated form.
My documentation.
Capitano's order is for someone who speaks Catalan. I am not a Catalan speaker. I speak Andalusia.
Are you authorized?
Galicia.
Annette, are you authorized?
My dottore card is expired.
Your dottore card is expired?
Yes.
What? But
I can't play dottore.
Well, do you have another one? Do you have a related?
I do have my Orazio.
Oh, good, thank God. You've got your rocks, and you're playing Flaminio today. That's all right. It's related.
Yes,
you can do that.
Did you say you needed someone to fill in today?
Yes, because
we have the
drunken sailor part needs to be filled in, and then there's the second Donna. I didn't tell them about the second Donna, but that's
I got it.
You got something. Okay, make sure you're authorized because we have to have everybody authorized and warranted and all of that because you have to do that. All right. So, my lords and ladies, I give you E. Firenzi doing the Fake Tofano.
Oh, my brother. My friend and brother Orazio, that man will never come again.
Flavio, that was the best prank, the best trick we have ever done.
That Capitano Spavento will never show his face around here again.
Never again, mainly because it's buried about a foot deep in mud.
Well, you know, when you got a nose like that and it sticks in the mud. That's right, yeah, but I tell you squatting down behind him, and I just kind of walked up.
I was
right there on the edge of the ditch.
Yes. But it was a fabulous idea. To you.
I thank you for your help. You were instrumental in this.
What's all this noise I hear?
Hello, Isabella.
Oh, hi there, Orazio.
How are you doing?
What's this I hear about the Capitano?
Oh, he won't be bothering us anymore.
Never again.
Never again.
Good riddance.
Oh,
yeah, he's gone.
You should see it. We lug him into a ditch.
Yep.
Oh my God. I'm so glad we won't see him around here. Not with that nose and the helmet.
I forgot about the helmet.
It's filled with mud now.
Did I hear something about a helmet and a nose? Is my Capitano nearby?
He will never bother you again, my lovely Flaminio.
Hello, Flavio.
I just love being around you.
Yes, I know you do.
You are my sun, my stars. But you don't have to worry about that Capitano fellow. He's gone.
They got rid of him.
Gone. How can he be gone? I'm in love with him. He's my true love. How can I live without my true love?
I'm right here.
Not you. You Pam.
How do you love Capitano?
Capitano, he's the sweetest, most gentle soul there ever was.
We're talking about Capitano Spavento.
Yes.
The slayer of a thousand Turks.
Oh, he wouldn't actually hurt anybody.
The sailor of all the seas.
No, he wouldn't actually go anywhere.
The best swordsman in all of Europe.
He just uses it for show. No, really, this is the sweetest, most gentlest.
You know, I can't believe that laugh.
Maybe, but he's drawn on me at least that many times.
Well, I tell you, Capitano Spavento is a sweet and beautiful, beautiful person. And if you hurt him, you made him go away!
Petrolino!
Petrolino, these men are horrible. They've done something to my Capitano.
You did this to her?
I
like your
Pantalone. We were just talking with your daughter and...
What? Why are you talking to my daughter? That's...
Because she's so pretty.
And beautiful and great at poetry.
Yeah.
And yeah.
She is. And I want to talk to you about her.
Signora Pantalone.
Yes.
These two young men have reduced your daughter to absolute tears.
What?
Well,
you haven't seen her. She was
no.
She was giving you the words. She was just going.
He's a pimp. What?
No. What?
Are you trying to shut up my daughter?
No, Signora Pantalone. You know everything I do is in faithful service to your household. If I was pimping anyone, it wouldn't be your daughter, and you would be getting a cut. You know that's how this
You've
works.
You've been cutting him out of the cut?
Oh, oh yeah, you don't yeah, do that.
You don't do
Mama,
that.
Mama, these boys, they're horrible. They're a bad influence on the neighborhood.
No,
they can
no,
see
no.
the horrible going
on. No. See what I'm saying?
No.
Papa, do not look at this woman. She's my age.
I know.
been a little while.
Well, Isabella sent me to find them, plus Flaminia is going to charge them with murder.
Yes, they did murder Capitano.
But I've got to warn them. We can't have them charged with murder.
We might need to go look for them.
Yeah, well, you know what? Flaminia, why she's doing this, it's not because he's dead or anything. It's because she was in love with him.
I was starting to figure that out. System with the complaint, I'm gonna go over to the boys and I'm gonna extort them for a little money, maybe even give some of it back to Pantalone.
Oh, Papa talked about this. He did. He talked about this once. It's the old Pantalone family tradition.
Exactly.
Extortion!
Yes, Flaminia, your first extortion.
My first extortion!
You get to be part of the family business. I know you can do this, Flaminia.
I'm so... Oh, Pedrolino, you're brilliant! Oh, you're brilliant! Oh, thank you! I will do this and Papa will be proud, and I will find the murderers of my... It's okay! I will find the murderers, and they will confess, and I will finally get to do my first extortion.
See, you just leave it to me to come up with some kind of scheme, and finally everything gets resolved properly.
Hello, Pedrolino. I can't believe that Francesquina said we
can't be charged with murder.
We didn't kill anybody.
Except for the guy you shoved in the ditch.
We did not kill him.
In that river.
There's no proof of that.
That's a legend.
It's merely a rumor.
It's a rumor that looks an awful lot like a dead body to me.
You saw a dead body?
I may have.
Floating in the ditch?
Where else would he be? It's not like you moved him out.
It's all your fault. You
and my fault? No, it was your idea. I just went along with this.
I can't believe you got me into this.
I'm not the one who got you into this. You said it'd be a great idea to get rid of him. So that way, you could have Flaminia all to yourself.
Yes, well, it was a good plan.
At the time...
What was this plan that was so good? I have details. Come on.
No.
He might rat us out. Don't tell him anything.
Tell you what. What would it take if you didn't know anything?
Flavio, you can't trust him. Pimp!
Oh, you're right.
What?
You're right. You said he's nothing but a
pimp. Everyone always called him. I told you. I just saved your life.
Signorina Flaminia.
Flaminia. Hello, Flaminia.
Flaminia.
Hello, Flavio.
Oh, she said my name.
Hello, Rossio.
Yeah, see, she's a natural.
Yeah, hi. Yes, hello, Flaminia. How are you today?
I am... really well.
That's good. And what makes it such a great day?
Oh, I'm surrounded by the most wonderful men.
Yes.
And I'm so happy.
You're happy?
I'm so happy because today I discovered I am freed.
You're free.
I am freed from that horrible Capitano Spavento.
Yep. I know.
Yes, he's gone and I no longer have to worry about him following me around, smelly and long-nosed as he was.
Well, you know.
Well, that was my idea.
That was his idea.
Really?
And yes. I helped.
You helped.
Yes. Yep.
Tell
we
me more, loudly and
quickly. Well, you see, here there was he was by the ditch, and we were going along, and
mine was on
there
business.
He was with his helmet,
his
long nose.
And then Flavio had this great idea that
white
your idea.
Yes, it was my idea.
Oh.
And he said, if you go and stand behind him, get on all fours and kneel down.
Oh.
Yep. And then I walked up and I said, oh, Capitano, and he turned his back to Orazio, and I pushed.
You pushed?
Yeah, and he fell over.
Tumbled.
Oh, into the ditch.
Wow!
It was wonderful.
That's a magnificent story. I could just imagine him in his tall, thin, beautiful Spanishness with the helmet and his nose and his
That's it! Go!
He really believes what he believes, and you know, that's That's...
What was all of that noise? What happened down here?
Hello, Isabella. Tell you what, why don't you come down here and I'll tell you about it. Yes.
What?
Hello, Isabella. Well, you know, it was Orazio. He was scared again.
Oh, scared? What was it this time?
He said a ghost.
Oh,
but I don't think it was a ghost. I think it was just a sheet flapping in the wind.
Oh, poor
thing. He wouldn't. Yes.
Was it the ghost of Capitano?
That's just a rumor.
Oh. Well, you know, I think I know why you pushed him in the river. You did it for love, didn't you?
Yes, I'm in love with Flaminio.
Oh, it's so wonderful. Oh, I mean, you know, all of the things we do for love.
Yes, all the things we do, like trip people.
Well, you know, all the things that I do for Orazio.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Like?
Lustful and lascivious, can't hold it.
You didn't tell me that.
Yes, he's down and dirty, walks on the beach.
He's my best friend and he hasn't told me these things.
And lewd and lascivious poetry editing.
No, no.
Oh, yes.
He would have told me that if he had done that.
Oh, he do it what all the time.
Of, I don't know. What. Tell me more.
Oh, yes.
What else do you get?
Oh, there was that one time that we said, oh, yes, we were serving.
Oh, really?
Those things? We do those things, huh? And you, how did you do that with my best friend?
It's just a misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding? Really? How dare you?
Oh, just tell him
this. No,
no,
neither of us. How dare you do those things with him? Flavio, that was, she's supposed to hold my hand. And
it wasn't like that.
I will not stand for this.
Well, don't fight over me.
I challenge you, sir.
I really can't fight with your father's sword.
Well,
it's special to you.
It is my favorite.
Yeah.
But I can't fight you unarmed. Take it.
No.
Take it.
No.
Take it.
No.
Fine.
I'll get you.
I'll get you first. Just
oh, no.
Kids.
Oh, no. What have I done? Can possibly, you know, kill each other. That would never happen. It'll be fine. They'll just, you know.
I can't believe how out of hand everything's getting. Now a man's dead and all over a woman. And
oh no! Oh no, Magdalena! Oh no! What? He's dead! Oh god, he's dead and it's all my fault! What am I doing? Oh no!
Your fault?
Oh god!
Isabella having shoved into the beach?
Oh, no.
What? That makes no sense!
Oh my!
Oh, Pantalone, I do love our tours to the poor part of town. It's so nice to see how the other people live.
Oh, so quaint, isn't it? It's amazing. It's amazing what these people do without any money.
They have so little.
You have to be so creative.
I know.
What was that thing about Pedrolino you were trying to tell me about?
Oh, Pedrolino. Pantalone, as I told you earlier, that man is not to be trusted. I should know. With a woman's intuition, I know men like that. That's the kind of man it would take a young, poor, rich, innocent, noble woman and take advantage of her.
Yes,
I imagine.
What is she talking about? Signora Pantalone, I have been in your household for many years and I have never done anything of the sort. Of course not.
He's a liar.
Well, not
he
from you.
Liar.
Ah!
I've stolen some for you, you know, because you insist. But never from you.
He's a scoundrel! A liar and a scoundrel!
Sarah,
I hate him. Horrible. Just horrible. Just horrible.
Signora, I am your most faithful servant. And your only servant because the others left when he wouldn't pay them.
He's only sticking around so that he can use your daughter. There, I said it. He'll treat your daughter like a bawd.
Signora! What are... There's no basis for any of this. Just...
Keep my master's ghost walking in the streets! I've seen my master's ghost!
His master does seem to be walking about the streets of Rome, yes.
What's this kind of crazy mind?
I don't know.
He is a servant to the Capitano who got shoved in the ditch.
He's just walking around, and he still has his note, and
run from me, from Capitano, Tomas, Luis, Victoria, Diego, Ortiz, Spavento.
Okay.
What is this?
You're a ghost.
Ha, ha, no. I am, however, an aggrieved man. Aggrieved at your daughter.
My daughter?
Your familia has betrayed me with that Flavio. So perhaps we should run from this. What can you do to make this better, old man?
Oh.
Shall I kill her after I kill him?
No. Flaminio!
What do I hear? I hear the dulcet tones of my Spanish beloved! Oh, there he is! He's actually alive!
I am not your beloved.
You shunned me.
I saw you dilly-dally with that Flavio.
Oh,
and now,
no.
I shall kill you.
No, my beloved, no, I was lying, just like my papa taught me.
I have to save my son.
No. Oh, papa, I was trying my first extortion.
Yes,
you're so funny.
My beloved believed the lies I was delivering very, very skillfully for Flavio and Orazio, and now he doesn't
really know it's all your fault!
Signora, did you just hear her? She was trying extortion. See, what we're doing is she pretended to hate Capitano to get Orazio and Flavio to confess what they had done so that we could extort them for money, or maybe bureaucracy if you listen to her.
It was perfect! It was the perfect plan!
And we were going to finally put a little something in your money bag?
And I was finally participating in the Pantalone family tradition of extortion!
And she did wonderfully. And now that it's done, we do have to find Capitano and get everything cleared up.
Okay, let's go find him.
I think he went this way.
This is the part of extortion they don't put in the manual. Oh, I hope my papa can help me. It's so important that my true love really believes that I was lying on his behalf and not with the other.
Friends, some best friend he is. And the love of my life just up and goes with my best friend, and I don't know what to do. They're all traitors and...
Yeah, they're all traitors and people are horrible.
I shall comfort you.
Is it Orazio? Is he alive?
Oh, it's just Isabella.
Isabella.
Rossi!
Come closer, yes.
You!
Yeah. Oh, no!
What did you do with her, of all people?
It was because of you! You and Flavio!
Flavio. I need to find Flavio. He'll help me. He always helps.
Especially, signore.
So, the wedding canvas.
Of course it can.
Oh, okay.
I'm sure Pentamonium can make me rich.
The wedding.
You have your access to the Spanish trade.
Ooh.
And I shall have my Italian woman.
Yes.
Now, perhaps we should go inside and make some arrangements for all the details.
Capitano, I'm a rich woman and not used to begging, but for my son, I won't do this terrible thing. Capitano, please don't kill my son.
Relax, Madonna. It is all understood.
Oh, well, that was really easy. I was going to offer you women that. Not me, but women and wealth and land and all that. But if you agree, that's fine. Okay. Thanks.
Well, let us not be too hasty.
No, you've already agreed, and the deal's a deal, Capitano. It's fine.
Italian!
Do I hear those dulcet tones again? Is it truly my love? Do we, in fact, have a resolution to our little misunderstanding?
You are right.
Oh, Papa, tell me, I may live happily ever after with my beloved Capitano?
Oh, it's just a wedding, yes.
No, wedding! Oh, my Capitano and I, we will live happily ever after with that nose.
Well, we should come inside and discuss this.
Excellent, yes, let's discuss it and all the wedding arrangements, and we'll find all the right musicians and the best food and the best wine.
We'll talk about the food.
And by we, I'm pretty sure she means me. And now for a brief nautical interlude. Baby soldiers three.
Soldiers three?
Two!
Two!
Baby soldiers two. Pardonne-moi, je vous en prie.
I have a magazine in my head.
No! Yes. We be two poor mariners! We be two poor mariners! Newly come from the sea! We spend our lives in jeopardy! Whilst others sit at ease. Shall we go dance this round, and shall we go dance around, around? And he that is a bully boy, let me on the ground, the ground. Act three.
Right out. We're girls. We can't just
Yes. Food. I love food.
Oh, Flavio, I'm so sorry, my brother.
I'm sorry.
Can you ever forgive me, bro?
Can you ever forgive me,
bro?
Bro. Wait. Did I hear something?
Wow, God, that is a lot of food.
I can see it now. It'll be the most beautiful wedding. All the best flowers and the best musicians. Oh, it'll be wonderful. We'll get that Master Dunstan. Oh, it'll be excellent. Do not get Master Effingwater. No, I'm sure to get Master Dunstan. Dunstan is the most wonderful. He does the most beautiful cascade.
Oh, yes, of course he does. Yeah, we'll make sure to get the musician.
It'll be the most beautiful wedding ever. I'm so excited. Well, I am going to go practice and make sure that everything for my underthings and my overthings are all perfectly adored and all the frilly little things that you like.
Okay, Pedrina. Now, forget about all that. All you need to worry about is you need to get the cheapest, most affordable musician you can. I don't care if you play armpit farts.
So, Master F.
As long as he doesn't charge much, it's good.
Okay, so maybe not Master F.
You get the point.
We did just have a musical interlude. How about? No, wait, she's still drunk on stage. We can't.
No.
Well, I'll find someone.
Good. You know the type I like, right? Oh, one other thing. Yes. One other thing. Please don't forget to invite Isabella to the wedding.
Don't forget that.
Invite Isabella, okay.
Yes, her father is...
I'm sure she would be delighted to be there.
Good.
All right. All right, leave you to your work.
Run along.
All right. Signorina Isabella!
Yes? Oh, hi, Petrolina. I'm not doing anything suspicious right now, no.
I'm sorry. Signorina Isabella, I just wanted to make sure that you were coming to the wedding.
Oh, the wedding of Flaminia. Right. Why would I want to go to the wedding of Flaminia?
Well, perhaps your true love will be there?
Oh, yes, my true love. Flavio. Flavio will be there. Right.
Flavio pushed the groom into the ditch. Yes. Yes. I will make sure that Flavio who pushed the groom into the ditch comes to the wedding.
Well, if you can make sure Flavio is there, because clearly Flavio is the more manly, exciting, wonderful, heroic man of this neighborhood, then yes, I will be sure to be there.
I will come up with some kind of a scheme.
You better.
Again.
Hello, Petrolino.
Flavio!
Yes,
it's a man I was looking for.
Really?
I have two different favors to ask you, and I think they go well together.
Really? What can I do for you?
Well, so let's start with what I need to do for you.
Oh?
I'm going to sneak you into Flaminia's wedding.
You will!
Yes,
Flavio. Yes! That's great.
Okay, so that's one favor he can do for me. Now, the other one is. Yeah. And this is how we're going to do it.
Okay.
You've been taking a few music lessons.
Yes, I have.
Need to put you in a disguise.
Put me in a disguise.
So that Signore Pantalone won't know it's you.
How about if we put me in disguise?
And then you'll be a musician.
I'll be a musician. I can be a musician. Yes, I can be a musician for the wedding.
Yes.
And I can get in.
And that way you get into the wedding. Okay, we've got a deal.
Got a deal. Yes. Yeah, I got it.
Everything works out nice. Signora, are you all right?
I have a message. A message for
Ferruccio.
Tofano's boat is in the harbor. He's home. Oh. He's home. Tofano's boat is in the harbor. He's home.
Okay,
he's having dinner.
He's having dinner.
Isabella needs to know.
She needs to know. That's great, Signora. I know Isabella. I can take the message for you. Now, is this empty? It had better be, because this is a dry set. All right, well, we'll get you off stage to sleep off what was in there, and I will pass your message along to Isabella.
Oh, wow, that was close.
Yeah, I don't think they saw it, but you heard what she said. She said, Tofano is in town. You gotta go. Yeah, I think we are. I think you are. You gotta go talk to him.
I'm gonna ask Isabella.
And if that, and if that doesn't work, we can kidnap Isabella.
That would be great.
Yes, it is I, a manly man, free to go about town doing whatever business I wish, because I'm a man.
I like the freedom.
Yes, freedom.
Yes.
Clearly, manly men can do whatever we want, hatch whatever schemes we want, yes.
Maybe we should go down to the tavern and pick a fight.
Oh, yes.
I feel like fighting.
Of hearty ale.
Signora Tofano.
Yes, Tofano. Me. That's me.
Yes. I've been looking for you ever since I heard you got off the ship. You're looking very...
manly.
Manly?
Yes.
Today. You've been working out a little bit?
Yeah.
Anyway, it's been... let me catch my breath. 500. Okay, it was like 10 feet running. I've come to ask you, can I please have Isabella's hand in marriage? I love her with everything I have, and I just... But, why?
You!
What?
Marry my beautiful, wonderful, splendiferous daughter, Isabella!
Yes!
The thought is hilarious! Why would I ever stoop so low as to marry her off to the likes
because I love
of you.
She's my everything. She's my stars. She's my sky. She's my earth. She's my oxygen. She's the air that I breathe. She just makes me feel wonderful and complete and whole. And
hear my words. You will never marry Isabella.
What? No. No, God, no. Why? Oh, no, why? What have I done to deserve this? What? Oh, no. There's got to be something I can do. Oh, where's Flavio when I need him? Oh, man. There's got to be something. There has to be something. Anybody? I'm kind of up here. No? Not at all? Oh.
Extortion!
I'm no good at extortion! I'm more brawn.
Some of my merchandise make more money than he'll have money.
Yeah.
I think I could use a son-in-law just like you.
Oh, really?
Yes, yes, I think
that this is my daughter. Oh, I can't wait. I'll write some contracts up
and we'll make some business arrangements. I'll give you my promise. Just be patient.
Thank you. Oh, I can't wait. I've got so many ideas about the cake and the venue and what colors we're going to have and what we're going to wear and what you're going to wear. I'm so excited. This is going to be fantastic.
Maybe I don't want a son-in-law with that kind of slant.
Yeah. Well, I think it'll be fine. You can do worse.
It'll be fine. I promise you, I shall be patient and wait.
You have my word.
Thank you, Signora. Thank you so much. Thank you. Oh, this is such a wonderful place. Cake that is about as tall as me. Blue, red.
Where's that musician?
A little bit of Signore Pantalone. I found you a musician, and he is not Master Effenwald.
Nope.
definitely not Master Effenwald. Oh.
Yes, I am Master Dunstan.
Oh, good, that's exactly who's...
Here's the best part. Fatalone, I told him, we can't pay you, but it'll be great exposure.
I get to expose myself?
No.
No. Not that kind of way. All right. Let me hear what you can play.
See?
Yes, you play those notes. Very good.
And he doesn't charge any money to do it.
That's my favorite kind of artist.
I'll just go inside now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Into the house. Oh, Signora Tofano.
Yes, Tofano, me. Yes.
Is it time yet? I'm pretty sure I've got everything planned out here, and I've been very patient.
Time for what?
The wedding, of course.
I just told you
that I could marry your daughter.
You must have misheard, because I clearly said you will never marry my beautiful, wonderful, splendid, marvelous daughter, Isabella.
But that's not what you said earlier, and now you're going back and forth, and you're so flipping floppy, and I don't know what to think anymore. I had all these plans, and I just can't. Why?
My word is final.
Why? I can't do this. I don't want to live. Please don't make me live. I'm dying.
Signora,
my heart is in a thousand.
Okay, no, I have an idea. I know it's not quite period, but.
Signora Pantalone, I'm going to keep this up. I need you to give him mouth to mouth.
There are some things worse than death.
then you're going to be all right?
No. It works. Just leave it to me.
No. I don't want to be all
right. Oh, that's for me.
Edwardino, go see if Isabella is not going into bed, but she needs to come to dinner. Go find her for me.
Why would you say such things? Yeah, why would you say such things?
Say such things like me. Patient. You're my future son-in-law.
But you told me I wasn't.
Future son-in-law.
You're my son-in-law. We need to make plans.
Really?
This has got to have license.
Oh, hello, Ernestino. It's happening again.
Do you like my dress?
Yes, Franceschina, it's a lovely dress.
I like my dress.
Now, Signor, is Isabella in there?
I haven't seen Isabella recently.
Isabella's not in the house.
Well,
no.
Yes, Signora Tofano, but you did just ask me to go check.
She's not in there.
you've checked yourself, okay?
Yes.
That would explain why you're now on this set of stage.
Of course. Why, where else would I be?
Something really weird is going on.
Isabella out there yet? Did she come over this way? Has she found her yet? Just give her the news.
Signora Tofano?
Do you like my dress?
Yes, Signora. But didn't you have Signora Tofano with you a moment ago?
I love my dress.
I know you do, Franceschina. But there's some kind of scheme going on here, isn't there? And it's not one of mine, and you know what that means? It means that by the end of this play, everything's gonna be in complete chaos, and if they'd just listened to me, it all would have gone so much better. But now I have to sort everything out myself.
Do you like my dress?
Oh, Franceschina, that's a new look for you. Look at you, Smith. Oh, Arlecchino. Well, you know, I was looking for Isabella, but I think I found something more interesting. What's going on?
Nothing, I was just looking for some food.
I don't know, I thought
you were
hiding something.
Always happy to make the eager acquaintance of another
young
dying woman. Now may not be the time, dear
thing. Let me my help.
Oh, the wedding is going to be so much fun.
I'm at a great price,
my
too.
Love, this is going to be great. I see you've met my Franceschina. This is going to be wonderful. I cannot wait for this. I'm so happy that you changed the world. We can't postpone it.
That is not
lessons.
We're gonna have an artist in the family! Oh my gosh, absolutely!
Oh my love, can you please ever forgive me for all that I have done?
Oh, I might forgive you if you were willing to do anything.
Anything, I try.
Even that one thing you said you would never do.
Oh no.
Yes. You know exactly what I'm talking about.
Okay, just only for a little bit.
Come on, Papa, we must discuss the marriage contract.
See, I told you, any time that there's somebody other than me with some kind of ridiculous scheme involving dressing up like your father or dressing up like each other or something, it never works. They really should have listened to me, you know? See, Franceschina, Arlecchino, this all could have gone so much smoother.
Everybody's mom got married. Why don't we get married?
Can I keep the dress?
I get the pants.
Deal.
Manus McDay.
Ibrahim Mustafa Haddad.
Katerina Carabello.
Jovan Donato.
Jennifer Wolfman.
Tessa Despina.
William Garrett.
And I'd like to let you know we have a friend who's taking care of a sick friend in a medical facility in Fairfax, Virginia, and he would normally be playing Pantalone today, and so with a whole 45 minutes of prep time, Ibrahim stepped in and did his thing. Save the play today, because the show must have gone. So thank you, everybody. Thank you so much. And right now we are at 3:30, and court goes on at 4 o'clock. So we are going to clean this up, reset for court. So please do come back in half an hour. And remember, if you're interested in documentation, as you should be, in a 501c3 educational organization, we have got it right here. So thank you very much. And one more round of applause for this extraordinary group.